Okay. Show me.
Hi there, guys. Welcome back to the Dr. C channel. Thank you very much for tuning in. And in this video, we're going to be taking a look at this here radio. A Jumper T12. Yeah, it's a pretty small radio, as you can see, but it packs a punch. Yes, it does. And one of the biggest punches it punches is this thing over here. This is a multi-protocol module, and with that module, this radio isn't limited to just one protocol, as most radios are. You can control hubs and quadcopters with it. You can use it for FR Sky receivers, Fly Sky receivers, Spectrum receivers, even some Futaba receivers. But the major thing with these is that you'd buy them for, say, toy grade quadcopters, right? If you want to fly a Hobson or WL Toys quadcopter, can be a lot of fun, especially indoors. But as you know, the radios that come with those quadcopters are meh. So with this radio, you'll have a better radio for all those kinds of quadcopters. Right? Okay, so in this video, I'm going to tell you why I personally ordered this Jumper T12 radio. We're going to be taking a detailed look around this radio, so what features it has. And I'll give you my initial impressions of it. And there'll be a surprising finding on this radio. A positive finding. It's the best radio for a certain type of pilot. But more on that in a couple of minutes. Okay, so why did I order this Jumper T12 radio? Well, I've kind of already told you the flexibility of it, right? Because of this multi-protocol module that's delivered with the radio, makes it a very flexible radio, right? It's also nice and small, so easy to transport. It's reasonably affordable. There is a link in the description. Check it out so you can see the current pricing. And I've been interested in the Jumper radios for quite a while, but you probably know the previous versions or the more affordable, cheaper versions of the Jumper radios. Those yellow radios, right? Yeah, I was interested in them. A friend of mine has one of those, so I tried it out. But those really felt too much like toy grade radios to me. Personal thing, those are smaller, the yellow Jumper radios, and they really were too small for my hands. Also, this Jumper T12 has OpenTX firmware on it, and the yellow, the more affordable Jumper radios do not, which makes this much more of an hobby grade kind of radio. And it also means for me that it's more of a radio that I want to endorse to you. Apart from me wanting to own one, that's a thing I take into consideration, right? Do I want to endorse things to you? And with this radio having OpenTX, there's an enormous wealth of knowledge on the internet about OpenTX. So that makes this radio much more appropriate for hobby grade RCers, in my opinion, of course. Okay, so I ordered this radio from Hobbycool, and there's a link, like I said, in the description. If you take a look at their page, you'll see that you can order this radio with or without this module. Maybe you want to use this radio for Crossfire or EverSky R9M. I doubt it, really. But you can. If you already have a module, you can, again, order this radio without a module, and you can use whatever module you want to use in it. Also, you have the option between this sand-colored version, which has analog sticks, But you can also opt for a black version, which has Hall Effect gimbals. And obviously that Hall Effect gimbal version is more expensive. A friend of mine has that black version, and to me the price difference wasn't worth it. To me. Personal thing maybe, but to me these, the analog sticks, feel good enough for what I want to use this radio for. Right? But okay, so if this would be your main radio, which is perfectly possible, in that case I'd probably go for the black version with the Hall Effect gimbals. The price difference is about $20, I think. Well, at the time I'm shooting this video. So again, check out the link and see what the current difference in price is. Okay, so that's why I personally ordered this radio. Let's have a close look at it. Okay, the radio came to me in this cardboard box, but courtesy to DHL, it's a little bit dinged up, as you can hopefully see. Yeah, but inside that cardboard box, the radio was packaged in this plastic blister-like packaging, which protected the radio well enough, so the radio itself wasn't damaged at all. So that's nice, thank you. The radio comes with a couple of things. One neck strap, a jumper branded neck strap. Now I personally never use a neck strap, but it's definitely nice that they include a neck strap. A battery holder for 4 AA's, so you can power the radio from 4 AA's. I personally use a LiPo in the radio, I'll show you in a minute. But well, you have either option. It comes with an antenna, 2.4 GHz antenna. It comes with a USB cable. And you can use that USB cable for two things. To upgrade the firmware in the module. Yes, the firmware in the module can be updated. Or you can use that cable to use the radio as a simulator joystick. And the last thing is this. Those aren't spares. With these parts, you can convert the radio into one that has a spring on the throttle channel. Ordinarily, of course, the throttle lever, the throttle gimbal, doesn't have a spring in it. But if you want to use this radio for a quadcopter that has an altitude hold, in that case you will want a spring on this axis. Right? You want this throttle stick to jump back to the center if you let go of it. So, with this set of hardware, you can add a spring to this stick. Very nice that they include that. So, a close look at the radio itself then. Obviously, it has two sticks. Yeah, and more on the sticks, on the feeling in a second. So, what my personal impressions are. But, well, these are analog sticks as mentioned. And again, this radio is also available with Hall Effect gimbals. Apart from that, however, and the color, the T12 and the T12 Plus are exactly the same. Just so you know. So, the T12 Plus will also have 6 switches. 2 position switch. 3 position switch. 3 position switch. 3 position switch, 3 position switch, 2 position switch, and no momentary switches. I personally kind of never use actually momentary switches, but well, if you like having momentary switches, this radio does not have momentary switches. It has 4 3 position switches and 2 position switches. It also has sliders, as you can see, 2 actually, one on either side, which is for an entry-level radio quite luxurious, right? For instance, the FRSky Q7X does not have sliders. However, these sliders do have quite a long range of motion. 1, 2, and a little bit. So, yeah, that might actually make it pretty easy to find the center. See, the sliders do not have a center notch. You can't feel
where the center is. But if you slide them down one complete action, if you will, you'll be in the center and one complete more. I hadn't actually considered that, but oh well, again, quite a long range of motion, so I'm not sure if they'd be handy for, say, flips. Probably for a camera gimbal for pitch and yaw motion on, or pan and tilt on your gimbal, these would probably serve to be very precise. And again, I think it's quite luxurious up and above that you actually get sliders on an entry-level radio such as this one. Okay, you've got digital physical trim buttons for four directions. No extra trim buttons, as you can see. You got six buttons around the screen for to navigate through the menus. And you've got this screen over here, which, yes, that screen is pretty small. Let me actually switch the radio on. There you go. I am not completely sure if it will show up well in this video. Oh, pretty okay, actually. But, well, it's small. It is backlit, though. Nice. Maybe it's mandatory, but I know of radios that don't have a backlit screen. So, but again, yeah, it's small and that stands to reason, right? It's a small radio. You can't fit a big screen in a small radio. Okay, and just like most modern radios, it doesn't have a mechanical on-off switch. If you want to switch the radio off, you'll have to hold the off button, on-off button for 4 seconds, and it'll switch off. And I personally rather have a mechanical switch. But, looks like that's not in the cards anymore in the current radios. Okay, at the top, we have ourselves one USB port and one trainer port. There's no cable included with the radio to do trainer stuff. This USB port can be used to use the radio as a simulator input. At the back of our radio, the thing we see mostly is this module. And you can easily take it out, of course, if you want to use a different kind of module. Well, you can easily take it out if you don't have a camera in the way, that is. But there it is. A standard GR style of a module bay. And again, you can use different kinds of modules as well. As you can also see, this module has a USB port of its own. With that, you can upgrade the firmware in this module. The radio also has these round things, which add quite a bit of comfort in holding the radio, so that's nice. And at the bottom, we have the battery bay. As mentioned before, I use a 2S LiPo. And that's the only kind of LiPo you can use in this radio. The plug over here accepts a 2S balance plug. So again, because of that, you can't use a 3S LiPo, regrettably. And there's also a memory card slot over here. There's no memory card included with the radio. But with that memory card, you can add storage space to your radio. So, the menu controls on this radio. You got these two buttons over here. The top one is the enter button and the bottom one is the return or back out of a menu button over here. And on your right you've got navigation buttons. This left button has a double function, well, triple function actually. A short press will get you into the model setup. So you can browse through all the pages which determine how your model behaves. A longer press on this button will get you into the global setup of the radio. So things like the date and beeps. As you can hopefully hear, my radio beeps a little. I like that. Stock, the beeping was off. You can change the brightness of the screen, the backlight. I've switched the backlight off for this section of the video. I think that'll help in you seeing what actually happens. But, well, all these settings are basically the same as in most any other OpenTX radio, so that's good. This is, by the way, not a how-to for OpenTX. I'll include a link up here to a playlist in which I'll put videos about OpenTX. For instance, how to set up a model, airplanes, quadcopters and such. And by the time you are watching this video, there might be more videos in that playlist. So check it out if you are new to OpenTX. So this is full OpenTX, even though the screen is small. You can, by the way, also browse through different screens. And this screen over here shows you the channel output. So it's a channel monitor, right? But you can switch that to different views. Over here you've got graphical representations of the gimbals and bars. This is actually very useful, and again common or the same as in other OpenTX radios. Here you can see numerical outputs of your sticks. So whatever works best for you, you can switch between several different ways of it showing you what all sticks and switches do. So that's nice. One thing this radio does not do is voice playback or wave file playback. On other radios I have, for instance, if I flip this switch over here, my radio say acro mode or armed, such things like that, or maybe your battery's voltage or flight battery voltage. This radio doesn't do that, regrettably. Okay, so what then are my first impressions of this Jumper T12 radio? Well, funny story. What do you do when you take out a new radio? You give the gimbals a feel, right? What are the gimbals like? Well, my first impressions of these gimbals were horrible. The travel was far too small, at least for me. But yeah, I'd say for most people, actually. So I was kind of all set up to give this radio a negative review. However, then I extended the gimbal sticks a little. Probably on most really low budget radios you can't extend the gimbals, but on these gimbals you can extend the sticks, and I've extended them for about 3 millimeters, I think. And with that small change, the radio is, well, completely flyable. Very, very nice. And you might have seen my simulator practice run or test run with this radio. After about a minute, I was kind of used to it. Yeah, it's a small radio, so that does take a little bit of getting used to, and definitely I prefer big radios. But it wasn't awkward or annoying at all, so that's good. Okay, and here comes the surprising thing. I am myself a thumb stick flyer, meaning I have my thumbs on the sticks, right? Some people are pinchers, which means they hold the sticks like so. Or maybe so. I'd call those people hybrid pinchers. But I always test or try any radio in both modes, if you will. And I was surprised to see that this radio is far, far better for pinchers than any other radio I've tried. It's partially the shape. It tapers down a little over here. All edges are rounded off a little. But as you can see, I can Well, I hope you can see that. The radio fits perfectly in my hands like this. And obviously I have full reach of the switches. Excellent. Now again, I'm not a pincher myself, but if you were looking for a comfortable to hold pincher style radio, amazing actually. Yeah, again, it's probably mostly due to the shape of this radio, but it makes it very easy to hold like this. Yeah, surprising, to me at least. Okay, the radio doesn't feel as plasticky cheap as I had expected. Yes, it is all made out of plastic, obviously, but it feels sturdy, well made. It is a little light in the hands. You probably could weigh it down a little more with a larger lipo. I have quite a small lipo in it, which works, but yeah, it does end up being a pretty light radio. And maybe you like that. I personally prefer a heavier radio. For children, however, so people with smaller hands, this could be a close to perfect radio. Okay, negative things on this radio. First thing, yeah, the screen is really, really small. Physically, the radio could have accommodated a slightly larger screen, I think, and that does make working with that radio easier, more comfortable. If your eyes work well enough, this screen won't be a problem, but again, I have radios with far larger screens and that's simply more comfortable. Second thing is the radio doesn't come with a protective case sleeve thing. Yes, and I do understand that if the radio would have come with a sleeve case thing, it would have made the radio more expensive, but I suspect that most people would be willing to spend an extra $5 to $10 or euros on a radio if it had come with a protective case, because this way you can't really throw it in your backpack. After a while those sticks will... Yeah, I'm not really sure if they get damaged, but I'd be worried about the switches and the sticks. So to hobby cool, I think it might be wise to add a small case to your inventory for this radio, so people can purchase the case with the radio. Okay, that's my initial take on this radio. From now on I'll be using the radio, so in a few weeks probably I'll give you a long-term review. After, well, let's say 50 flights, I'll give you a long-term review of this radio. So far, it's better than I had expected. If you are left with questions about this radio, hit me up a comment down below. Catch you on the next video. Bye-bye.